Two Harbors City Hall. There's the big rubber ducky. We're gonna take a walk down there and check it out. We're right over by the historic train depot. Tall Ships 2022. Yeah, well, let's go this way and we'll take a peek over there. I see some ships out there. Looks like a ore ship coming in. Sorry about my squeaky shoes. Should blame Nike. I gotta go get new ones. We're gonna check out the vendor setup here, see what we got going on. Must be selling beer tickets here or something. Complimentary Bible. Thank you. Here we are in the vendor area down by the big rubber ducky, down by the Edna G and the Sundew. Got lots of different vendors here. Ships back there in the background. Jehovah Witnesses here. Looks like we have some refrigerator magnets.
How we doing?
Okay, pretty good. Travel posters. Lots of vendors. And what do we got? What do we got? It's a big rubber ducky. And a whole bunch of vendors. Let's go check it out and see what we got going on. You can buy a rubber ducky shirt, of course. Hello. And here's the local yokels.
This is a guy you wanted to have focused
on. How's it going?
Very well. How about you?
Pretty good, pretty good. How's it been down here?
It has been a low-key couple of days. It's picking up now. It looks like we might actually see some crowds swelling here, Jose. I'm not sure.
Yeah, I think today will be a very much different day. I think today will be very much different. Down at the rubber ducky. Let's take a walk and see what we got going on here. Get your rubber ducky wear. Somebody's going to play here in a little while. Whiskey Company. Pickled Mary.
I'll tell you what. I will. If you would take down one of those pirates.
Smells like candles.
Can I?
Maritime Visitor Center.
Yeah, in Duluth.
Where's that at?
By the lift bridge.
Yep, right by the bridge.
Oh, okay. Yep. I'm dumb. I've been there.
And all kinds of free water safety swag. Stickers,
tattoos, and we're advertising our raffle.
Stickers here.
Wear
your life jacket.
Yeah. Especially if you're a young man. Statistically, you are at risk for suffering from not wearing a life jacket.
Yeah.
There we go.
Thank you.
Yeah.
And there's the Sundew and the Edna G. I think tomorrow we're going to go take a tour of the Sundew. And maybe one or two other boats tomorrow. We'll see. We'll see what we do tomorrow. Maybe even later today. We'll see.
No, we got some for our ready.
Hi. Oh, yeah. More and more vendors. More and more vendors. Cards and art, t-shirts and stickers, and all kinds of things. Rain gauges.
Thanks, folks. Have a good day. Yes, thank you.
Okay. Take a walk down by the Edna down there, see what goes on.
I think we can just walk down here.
In line to get on the Sundew. Kim will be on there tomorrow. I'm gonna go talk to the Edna G folks here and see what they have to say. I guess Kathy fell down and got injured. So, how's it going?
Hi. Yeah, it's going good.
Going good.
So far good this morning.
Yeah.
Yeah. So this is the booth for the Edna G. We've got a wonderful, brand new history display that was made for this occasion, with lots of great signs that show facts about the historic tugboat, and hoping to sell some merchandise to help raise money for the restoration. And we are missing Kathy Glenn, our chief person, who helped get us all this organized, and then was injured on Wednesday. So. hi, Kathy, and we're missing you. Okay, but we're doing good. We're doing good. Yeah, we're having a good time. And people are coming by and looking at all of the info, so it's a good time.
Looks like it'll be busier today than yesterday.
Oh, yeah, lots of
sure. Yeah. Have a good day, guys.
And whatnot, they were here on the Great Lakes back in the day. I grew up in Chicago, and I was almost 30 before I found out that Chicago was the fourth busiest sailing port in the entire Western world back in the 1880s.
You look out in Chicago on the lakefront or up the river, and you wouldn't see two or three tall ships. You would see 200 to 300 tall ships.
Idea where we are over there by the big rubber ducky down here by the food trucks. And people are flowing on down. So I could take a little walk and we'll go over by the dock, see what we see over there. Looks like prices at Johnny's Tacos are pretty good. Dogs are smelling good.
Okay, so you said a smoky and a dirty dog?
Yeah. Oh, he's doing film.
Thank you.
tunnel here. It's quieter. Generators running over there. Buses. Sun reflections to GoPro. What can I do? Like an advertisement for a smoothie company.
Thank you. And then get somebody to hold it for you if you need to. Dave.
Hi.
How's it going?
Pretty good.
Yes, you may photograph me. Thank you for asking. Okay, Cody, do it like that, right? And do it for the camera. And then Oksana, hop up and maybe help him out while he's around. No, you want to help out, Cody?
What do you want me to help with?
Go guys. Very good. Oh, I am talking to you. I forgot. What? I'm John.
I will run
nice to meet you. Where are you guys going?
I have a Sharpie.
All right, cool. I can't even see.
Yeah. Yeah, we're on.
In the bog and I took my chainsaw. We mostly do hand tools, but we use power tools. And I plunged it in the ground and it went all the way around the tree and cut the roots, and then we healed it over, and so then we have that natural strength of the root going into the trunk. So this is a knee, a tamarack knee, and this is a tamarack knee, so very, very strong. And the rest of this is white oak and fir oak.
Is the keel a T-shirt?
It is. It is. We hand do that with axes. A lot of kids, my 9-year-old homeschoolers, lots of folks. You guys want to hop on board and explore Alpena? You're welcome to. Go find the steerboard.
This is later Norse design.
It is very Nordic inspired, but pretty much all cultures would have done lap strength at some time or another. It's not just Viking. It's Bronze Age, Iron Age, Greece, all over the world. If you've got wood and sustainable technology, axes, and a strong arm, you can go. Yes. You can go ahead and hop in. And guys, you're just going to get your sea legs on a little bit.
Sorry to photobomb your photo there.
No.
Battery power and see if I got enough power to go over that way or not.
What's that?
Okay. Sidestep some little bit of traffic. Thank you.
Hello.
Hello.
Yeah. We're, I think, just at capacity. Maybe we'll have to come on board in just a minute.
I'm actually just doing a little walking tour.
Sure.
You guys gonna be here to all day tomorrow too, right? You're here the whole time.
Why don't you come on board? You can just walk around the ship.
Let's take a quick walk through. Out on the Charlie, and I believe you guys are out of Bayfield, right?
Superior.
Oh, okay.
Superior, Wisconsin.
Normally at Barker's Island then.
Actually, we're in Loonsfoot.
In what?
Loonsfoot.
Okay. I'll have to look that up and see where that is. Cool.
Just behind the quick trip.
Get hard for a get old. And it looks like my pal John Agek, he found a friend.
Yeah.
All right.
No, I got the. I got some penicillin. The girls in Florida were way too friendly.
I don't know if you heard that one. probably going to be out of battery power right about when I get out there.
Yeah.
Right, yeah.
You're done.
Breakwall. Minnesota Festival of Sail 2022. And it is about 11 o'clock Friday morning. Crowds will start building in more and more as the day goes on. It's nice and chilly out here. I think we're gonna call day two morning a wrap.